Hey guys, the content you're about to watch was shot live on Pessimist Productions Patreon on March 30th, and now it's being chopped up and given to you here on, what is this, the 2nd of April? You could have had this days ago, plus a ton, you know, hours and hours more show. The whole show was like 3.5 hours, and we do the show every month, and we do all kinds of other shows all the time. Exclusive Friday shows, exclusive content every Wednesday, tons of stuff going up on this Patreon all over the place. So check it out. We appreciate you. The Patreon link is down below. I won't hold you up anymore. Here's the content you clicked on. So here's Lil Nas X. Satan shoes have sent conservative Christian Twitter into a rage spiral. Okay. So here's a Saint. This is a company offering up these shoes. Mischief X, Lil X, Satan shoes. It's a Nike Air Max 97 modified. Contains 60 cc ink and one drop of human blood. 666 pairs, each individually numbered. Price tag is $1,018. Coming out March 29th, 2021. It's yesterday. By the way, they sold out in 1 minute's time. So here's a little Nas X here. I spent my entire teenage years hating myself because of the shit y'all preach would happen to me because I was gay. So I hope you are mad, stay mad, feel the same anger you teach us to have towards ourselves. So here's some conservative reactions to this shit. I hope Nike burns to the ground.
Huh.
All of a sudden, burning down buildings? Awesome. You know what I mean?
Sounds familiar.
You know, it's just like, they just don't have any fucking principles. They'll just go right from like, can you believe these savages burning down their own city?
Then when there's something they don't like, pastor saying this, yeah, by the way,
then all of a sudden they don't like something. It's like, I hope Nike burns to the fucking ground, goes bankrupt over this. First they use massive amounts of child slaves. Oh yeah, you care about that all of a sudden too, huh? And now they openly promote Satanism. Disgusting. Nike had nothing. This dude is so stupid. This is a company that modifies existent shoes. You think Nike is around going around modifying some Nike Air Max 97s for this special Satan promotion? There's an industry that modifies existent sneakers in crazy, kooky ways, and this is what that is. And by the way, because of idiots like this thinking Nike actually signed on to this, Nike is now suing this company. Here's a guy in Right Wing Watch with Lil Nas X saying he's going to sample this dude in a song.
Sweet.
Little thug, whoever, I had no idea who he was.
Whoa. Wow, I didn't even think that was a human voice at first.
I thought it was like sped up 2 times or something.
No.
We was riding this morning, Hudson said, well, you know what made him famous? I said, well, he said, you know, he was at Horses. So, got my horses and whatever that song. I was like, man, that song got a cool beat. I'll never be able to listen to it again. Bunch of devil worshiping wicked nonsense. Pentagram wearing on your Nike tennis shoe 666. You think I'm going to stand for that? You've lost your mind. You tell little Dash X I said so. Bunch of Satanism, bunch of wickedness, bunch of devilism, bunch of demonism, bunch of psychotic wickedness. I didn't know.
Woo!
Woo!
Woo! What the fuck? Can you imagine going and seeing that guy and not being like, wow, that dude's insane?
Yeah, be like, woo!
Republican, that lady's standing up, like applauding.
Republican governor of South Dakota, Kristi Noem, also took a pot shot. So he said, our kids are being told this kind of product is not only okay, it's exclusive. But do you know what is more exclusive? Their God-given eternal soul. Wait, I thought everyone had a soul. That's not exclusive at all. That's not exclusive at all. If everyone gets one, that's not exclusive. That's the opposite of exclusive. That's
but
inclusive.
You only have one, and I thought Jesus could save it. If
we're in a fight for the soul of our nation. Wait, now we share one soul? I'm confused. We need to fight hard, and we need to fight smart. We have to win. No, smarts waved your party goodbye a long time ago, brah.
What are you going to fight?
Here's Lil Nas X. With the fucking perfect response. You're a whole governor and you on here tweeting about some damn shoes. Do your job.
God, I love him.
All right, Lil Nas X is the president of Twitter. Lil Nas X is the president of Twitter. You heard it here.
You're a whole governor.
Yeah. You know what?
He's totally right.
Oh my God, he's the president of fucking Twitter. You're not on this level? Don't even fucking tweet. What good will it be for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit their soul? Matthew 16:26. Shoot a child in your mouth while I'm riding. Montero 108. That's the name of his song. Candace Owens, everybody's favorite. Uncle Thomasina, whatever. Aunt Thomasina, I guess. We turned George Floyd, a criminal drug addict, into an icon. He's not an icon. Like, the whole point of the
nobody
the,
did
the
that.
Point of George Floyd is not like, look, a perfect example of how to live a pure life of moral goodness. Like, no one has said that, you stupid cunt.
The pigs that murdered him made him a martyr for the movement.
Yeah.
He didn't do anything. We didn't do anything. The fact that he was murdered in the streets is what made him what he is. Thank you.
A little closer, everybody.
Sorry.
You're just drifting out of the camera.
I know. I'm like, woo. Okay.
There's just imagine an invisible wall there, you know?
All right. I'll try.
Yeah, try. George Floyd is not fucking a moral exemplar. He's an example of police brutality. Okay? We're promoting Satan shoes to wear on our feet. Who is we?
There's only 666 people that are doing that, by the way.
And not only that, but like one guy released a shoe. Like, have you never heard of fucking, like, there's tons of fucking merchandise and always has been with pentagrams and shit on it. Like, I got one over there. You see that? I mean, it's not, I'm talking about the, on the screen.
Though. Oh, I was like,
she's like literally looking like, what?
I was like, cool, we got a pentagram on the wall.
We got all kinds of pentagrams, dude. Like, we got shit with pentagrams on it. And
no,
Satan.
We do.
Who cares? Like, that's been around. That's not new shit. Hail Satan, man.
We got Cardi B.
We got Cardi B named as Woman of the Year. You don't got her, okay? She exists in the world, and someone named her Woman of the Year. You can be fucking, you're free to disagree with that. Like, you can have your own Woman of the Year. Candace Owens, Woman of the Year. Yay.
She's never going to win that, by the way.
I mean, she could win it from some conservative bullshit.
Yeah.
We're convinced it's white supremacy is keeping black America behind. How stupid can we be?
Jesus Christ.
Like, really, the core problem in black America, it's not the fucking shitty infrastructure. It's not the disproportionate fucking arrest rate, sometimes for the same crimes.
Or poverty.
It's not poverty. It's not... you know, being rejected for jobs that they're more qualified for than white applicants or anything like that. It's none of those things that have been shown and demonstrated empirically to be happening. It's fucking Cardi B's big jiggly ass and Lil Nas X selling shoes with a pentagram on it. That's what's really the down... And fucking daring to think the cops shouldn't have murdered George Floyd. Those are the real problems in the fucking black community right now.
Exactly.
Like, shut up, you dumb bitch.
God, I hate her so much.
She's so fucking stupid. The next person that fucking asks me to take her seriously is getting slapped. As an olive branch, you know, Lil Nas X also decided to introduce this other shoe. This good Christian shoe. You know, it's got John 3:16 in it. It's got the Chick-fil-A logo on it. My pleasure. Yeah. So then there was Caitlin Bennett. She said, it's weak like this. It's weak like these that I'm thankful to be blocked by Lil Nas X. He says, I still see your tweets, shitty pants. she says, do you still see your dad? Purely a racist joke, by the way. Like, because
absolutely.
Like, it's not like there's, I mean, if you're thinking like, well, maybe that's not a racist joke. Maybe he really does, is, you know, disenfranchised from his dad or whatever. He's not. No, him and his dad are actually close. His dad is actually supportive of him. So this is nothing but a fucking black, I don't like black people stereotype.
Right.
Nothing but it. Because this has nothing to do with who he actually is as a person. Meanwhile, she did actually shit her fucking pants.
I was just laughing at his reply to that, not what she said.
Yep, I might fuck yours, which is beautiful. And then, I don't know if they show it here, but like she was like, he threatened to rape my dad. It's like, bitch, we all know your dad wants it. Don't kid yourself. Yeah, he fucking bodied that bitch. And just like, she bodied herself saying that stupid racist bullshit, but everyone already knows she's a fucking Nazi cunt anyway. So who gives a shit? Here's his apology, which is, you know, I hated to see him apologize for it, but you know.
Okay, guys, I see everybody's been talking about this shoe, and I just want to come forward and say,
okay, let's try.
Oh, he got you again. They thought they were going to get apologized too. They're like, yeah, we broke him. We broke him.
God, he is dunking on him.
Church of Satan gave their nod of approval. Hook us up with a pair, fam.
Nice.
This is more on this.
Oh, no.
This is Montero, Lil Nas X reaction, a Christian's response.
Because we care so much about what you have to say.
I mean, we do. We're sitting here watching it, right? This is from Victoria Clark. Doesn't have a lot of subscribers, but this video has pretty good views.
Yeah.
Sitting around 12,000. So some people have paid attention to what's going on here.
Then the beast was allowed to speak great blasphemies against God, and he was given authority to do whatever he wanted for 42 months. And he spoke terrible words.
42 months?
Wait, 42 what now?
Against God, and he was given authority to do whatever he wanted for 42 months.
That's what she's trying to say?
I guess.
I don't know this Bible
and
verse.
And he spoke terrible words of blasphemy against God and slandered his name. They are the ones whose
she
meant name
okay,
was
so
not.
She was trying to say months, but she totally said mumps.
I'm just picturing 42 like
42 wealth, mumps, dude.
Like rising up on the blasphemers.
42 mumps.
She definitely said
what?
Mumps.
She said mumps.
Like clearly.
Hold on, let's hear it again.
42 mumps.
Mumps?
He was given authority to do whatever he wanted for 42 mumps.
I mean, she literally says mumps, dude. I don't know.
Mumps.
Mumps. I mean.
Oh, mumps. Lord. All right, lady.
Some people are saying they heard mumps, but I hear a P sound pretty distinctly.
It sounds like mumps.
Hold on.
Whatever he wanted for 42 mumps.
There's definitely a P. By the way, that Revelation quote that she went through there, then the beast was allowed to speak great blasphemies against God. He was given authority to do whatever he wanted for 42 months. And he spoke terrible words of blasphemy against God, slandering his name in his dwelling. That is, those who dwell in heaven, blah, blah, blah. None of this has anything to do with Lil Nas X's video. It's tangentially related, but, like, there's nothing in that scenario.
Right.
Like, if she's trying to say that, like, Lil Nas X is, like, this Bible verse, like, coming to fruition or something, like, that's preposterous.
Like, how many depictions of the devil have been in media before now?
Like, all of a sudden, like, this one, it's like, what does this depiction of Satan have that the other ones don't?
Gayness.
Oh, right. There's a dude twerking on his, like, if this was a chick twerking on the devil, would we see the same reaction? They want to pretend like the devil part is what's got them upset, right. And it's not. It's just not. They don't give a flying fuck about the devil being in this video or the Satan shoes. This is 100% about him being gay and fucking flamboyantly so.
In Lil Nas's X video,
uh-huh.
That's what he's doing. He is trying to find a way to seduce the devil. And at the end of it, he gets sodomized by the devil. But if you can remember...
No, at the end of it, he literally snaps the devil's neck and, like, steals his horns.
Yeah.
And is like, I'm the new devil, bitch.
There's no, like, actual gay sex at all.
Yeah.
He's just dancing on the devil.
This is actually not the first person I've heard saying that he fucks the devil in the video. And, like, I watched the video and, like, I did not see him fuck the devil in the video or the devil fuck him. Like, I didn't see any penetration happen. So I don't know. I don't know what's being discussed here.
There's no like blatant nudity or anything.
Yeah.
So
the devil was like twerked on and then killed and then his horns were stolen.
Yep.
So I don't know.
In Sodom and Gomorrah, the Lord, you know, destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah.
Gomorrah?
Gomorrah?
Okay.
How many mumps did it take?
Off of the